see if he has anything to say. I have area code 734. Or no, I'm sorry, 740. Hello?
Hey, B.
Hey, how's it going?
Yeah, it's Ben.
How you doing?
I'm doing good. Just got out of the A-team.
Oh, so what'd you think about it?
It was fun.
Well, don't you think that's the kind of movie, like, perfect summer movie?
Perfect.
I mean, it doesn't require a lot of intelligence, but...
Well, of course not, but the show wasn't really a very intelligent show either. I remember watching that when I was a kid.
Well, what I liked about it is you don't have to see the show. Like, sometimes they come up with these movies, and it's like you feel like you don't know what they're talking about, who are these characters, you don't care.
I
just felt like they did a good job.
The Last Airbender
kind of...
was like that.
Oh, really?
That's what I've been told by a couple people who've seen it already, that it sucks, and it, unless you saw the show, you wouldn't know what was going on.
Man up! Get in the plane! We gotta finish the escape! Man up and get in there!
Putting the team back together.
So how do you plan on stopping
them? Don't sweat them.
This just got exciting.
I'm BA. You're gonna be unconscious.
Just a heck of a beautiful place. Is it timeshare? I'd love to get in.
Good morning!
He tried to escape by jump-starting an ambulance.
With a defibrillator.
Clear! My kind of guy.
I told you the mission wasn't over.
What are we talking about? Clean record?
Benjamin, so if you guys want to give your take on it, since you both have seen it, because I don't want to deny you that opportunity to share your love of this.
Did you see it, BDiddy?
Yes, I saw that a couple weeks ago.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm,
so,
all right, I'm the odd man out. I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, I'm the odd man out also. I haven't seen it. I think it's fucking awesome.
Either way.
The only reason
the
I got to see
coming
it,
out of the sky and the dude coming out shooting the gun.
Hey, yeah, you
that,
see that?
That
it looks
like,
ridiculous.
Nah, man.
Yeah,
when I saw that trailer, I thought it was the
stupidest
movie I ever saw when I saw that trailer. Because
it is so damn ridiculous. It's great.
But when I saw the rest of the movie,
believe me.
It didn't bother. Then I liked it. I didn't expect to like it.
Yeah, and it is good. I'm telling you,
it's
it is good.
It's a fun movie to watch. It's like
and I won't call it a guy movie.
BDiddy
got mad at me for calling it a guy
movie. Did you stay after the credits? Because they had a couple of the original characters from the show.
I was tired. I was so tired. I had to leave. I mean, people were staying
there. A couple more minutes. You were so tired. What are you talking about? It wasn't that long.
A couple more minutes?
The credits don't go on for that long. What the heck?
I didn't know. No one told me. No, I'm just saying, no one informed me that there was like a little extra scene after the credits. I didn't stay. You know, but the movie itself, it was fun. I didn't hate old dude, the UFC fighter. I didn't hate him as BA, as Mr. T.
Right,
I didn't hate him.
I think the guy from this.
I liked him a lot in that. I thought I wasn't going to. But he did a great job. Ben.
So you liked him as a Mr. as a
Oh, yeah, yeah. And I loved the dude from District 9. I thought he was great.
Charto Copley. He was the greatest. He was the greatest part of the whole damn film.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, because he was great in District 9. And after District 9, I was saying, you know what, that guy was fucking amazing. I hope he gets more work.
No, but you have no idea. I mean, he's a total different character in this damn film.
No, I get that, because I've watched the original series. Once I heard that, like, Charto Copley's playing Hal and Mad Murdock, I'm thinking, that might be a pretty damn good choice.
No, they made a perfect choice with him. Perfect.
Oh, good.
Liam Neeson, he was a pure badass in that shit too.
Like the last seven movies he's done. I mean, what, Taken, Batman Begins, fucking, he was a Jedi,
Narnia.
Benjamin David, what did you think about the special effects?
Lion's still badass.
Yeah. What
What, you saying,
what, did, what did you think about the special effects at the end, Benjamin David? Or BDiddy?
Oh, well, I mean, you mean when the cargo
tanker.
Ship was,
yeah.
Yeah, the tank. It wasn't, I mean, there were moments where you could tell it was kind of fake, some of the bunkers that were being crushed and stuff, but it, you know, it was still hilarious and fun to watch, and 10 times better than the special effects on the show.
Yeah. Oh, well, of course.
Yeah, I would hope so. Otherwise, what's the point?
I was just mad.
There were a few times I wanted to see some of those like crappy effects jump in there, just like
Well, that's what MacGruber was.
Mr. T.
Well, they did do that with B.A. Baraka's coming in on a dirt bike, jumping in a, you know, in a.
Yeah.
That was straight out the TV show.
Just, that's the problem, though. See, he should have been like, you pity fool, after he did that. That would have been the best
cameo
part of that
from,
line.
John Hamm from Mad Men.
Oh, wait, he was in this?
Yeah, he was in there. He had a little cameo there at the end, yeah. John
Holy
Hamm from Mad Men was
shit.
In there.
Was he the other like
shit,
a?
Why didn't you say so?
The other CIA guy.
The other guy was in the Watchmen. Patrick Wilson. He was the other CIA guy. He was in the Watchmen.
Night Owl 2. Don Hamm. Shit, Don Draper in an 18 movie. Why didn't you say so? I'm running right now to the theater.
Yeah, but he doesn't have a big part though. That's the only thing.
I was just joking.
I know, but I'm just saying, I just don't want you to be like all pissed. Like, you told me he was in that movie. I'm let you know it's not a very big part.
Yeah,
that's the only reason why you're gone, you're going to be disappointed.
Yeah, if I wanted to see John Hamm be awesome, I'm going to wait for season 4 of Mad Men.
Hold up, Jordan.
It's coming out in a couple of weeks.
When they were talking about them flying a tank, like during the like spill review, I was like, hey, they ain't flying a tank. But no. They're flying a tank. I mean, they use the tank gun like position themselves
to propel it, yeah.
over a river and shit, and then like to slow themselves down. I mean, they literally fly a tank. One damn parachute.
Wow.
I thought it was.
I'm willing to see that.
Everybody's on that plane.
We ain't on that plane.
Hey, boss, a little stuffy. I'm gonna pop the window. Yeah! What you got? What you got? Yeah! We're gonna fall in time!
Because the plane exploded!
What? When?
Recently!
I like the way you would, they would map everything out, and you got to see it as they were doing it, as opposed to just, like, going back. Like, every time they did something, you got to see how it played out, how they, you know, worked it out, which I thought was kind of cool the way they did that.
Oh, yeah, Prince Law, they brought in this damn plane, man, to do a bombing run. And, I mean, it was looking straight out of Call of Duty. And they actually, like, mentioned
man,
that. They're like, this looks like just like Call of Duty.
May I ask? Ratings all around from you all?
I say,
I would say full price because I'm sorry, I like that movie a lot.
I say full price as well. Especially
good.
After the last Airbender.
I think Benjamin David would, I guess Benjamin David would probably say it was okay. Like Toy Story 3.
Oh, fuck you, B.
I just said Airbender, I'm gonna fuck you.
It was okay.
Benjamin David,
that's great.
What's your review?
I saw Toy Story 3 last weekend, and I thought it was awesome, so that's all I'm going to say.
But no, I'd say it's a matinee. It's not it's not something I think everybody would go see and enjoy, but it's
okay,
definitely well worth watching.
Okay, if that's matinee, what's Toy Story 3 then?
Full price. Huh?
Oh, okay. All right, just checking. So
well,
full price.
I gave it a full price because I paid a matinee price to go see The Last Airbender when I walked out.
You
know, so I
gotta
pay
to make up the difference.